would like to invite Mr. Ajay Koshi to start the discussion and first of all talk about whether it's really, what does he face working in Brigade? Is it really a battle? Is it more of collaboration? What are his struggles? What are his pain points with architects? And how does it see, how does it go moving forward? What does he see the future to be?
First of all, thank you, Brinda. Thank you, everybody, for having me here. Let me clarify, I'm an architect. I joined Brigade Group about 10 years ago from an architecture firm. So I have moved over to the darker side, as some people may call it. But it's not really a darker side. It is, you get to learn a lot more about buildings, construction, real estate, from the developer side as well. It is not a battle. It's purely collaborative, especially now what we're seeing recently. We have to be collaborative with the consultants, architects, designers. Otherwise, you will not come out with a successful project. Obviously, during the entire process of design, concept, schematic, DD, there will be misunderstandings, there will be difference of opinions, but that's where these small mini battles come into effect. Without these mini battles and without this difference of opinions, I personally don't feel you'll come up with a successful project, right? We need to get different viewpoints from architects, designers, that will help come up with a project that is successful.
You have worked quite a bit, Neelab, with Hafiz Contractors, architects, and you've worked with a lot of developers. What are your struggles, and do you really agree that it's a collaborative process and there is no battle, or what are your experiences and insights on this?
They have their own challenges, so considering the challenges that they face from the time that they have decided to go for a plot, then decide for the kind of building that they want to make, and then ultimately they have to get that design and go out into the market and sell it, and at the end of the day make some money. A lot of design is effectively about mathematics. It is not about so much like we talk about a regular design, it's a lot of mathematics in it. So I that way sympathize with them, and we understand. And I'm happy that Brigade Group and some of the other new developers who have got architectural teams within them have brought in a certain amount of professionalism into the way it functions. But the traditional approach has been, it doesn't follow any of the design processes of concept, schematic, design. All these things are unknown words in that community. It is, you've got a plot, you have to hit the ground 1 week later, and you have to design that in the 3 nights that you get in between. The whole of that process goes through, and you have to fit it in the mathematics that he needs it, and it has to be sold before it hits the ground, and that's the kind of speed at which it functions. And if you are into that game and you're willing to design and deliver at that speed, you'll be there. Otherwise, developer architecture is a completely different ballgame.
Working internationally, we have seen even at HKS, there's a lot of the developers are becoming more and more design driven as well, and there is a change in the mindset and in the traditional ways of working. However, yeah, it's still a nascent stage. There are still struggles that we face, and I would come to Sabina now, and if you could just tell us a little bit, working with M. Moser, how have you seen this evolve over the last 10 years in buildings and in interiors, especially workplace? And what have been your challenges working with the developer community?
You know, whether you're giving an X quality building or Y quality building, the demand in India right now is so huge that the building is going to be taken up. But there are some developers who are managing to make the maths work and to give a little bit of value add. So you're seeing things like wellness come in. You're seeing things like, you know, the quality of food courts, the quality of amenities are improving. But that the percentage of that is still quite less. And I think there's still some challenges.
And coming to Gauri, so there must be a lot of students here as well. And growing up, like when we were in architectural colleges, we all were taught things in a certain way. It's an idealistic situation. It lets us explore, But sometimes some of the aspects of the practical world where a lot of work is getting done by developers is not really something that is communicated or discussed a lot in architectural schools. And Gauri, at Edifice, you mentor a lot of young professionals and you see a lot of students come in. You also teach at RISVI. So what are your thoughts? How can we, what can the architectural education system do?
I've been teaching, when I was in Mumbai, I was teaching here. I've been attending design juries at colleges. What you see is two extremes, at least this is what I've observed, is they're either mimicking exactly what is happening outside, or they're at the other spectrum where they're completely impractical and they're only looking at the aesthetic. So I think there is a need in the education system to find a balance where, yes, you give them a chance to innovate, to experiment, because once you're in the practical world, probably that's going to remain to a 20%. And you're going to have to adhere to the market, to the cost, to all of the things that Manoj spoke about us in the morning. But at the same time, they need to be introduced to a certain level of practicality, especially when it comes to you know, construction methodologies, the new age technology in construction, or you know, what is bylaws. It needs to progressively get introduced in the course of 5 years, so that from year one to year five, there's actually a progression and you're not at two extremes where you're absolutely mimicking what happens outside or you're extremely impractical. So I think that fine balance is something which is missing today. We see a lot of students bring in, you know, softwares is what they believe they're getting judged on or gauged on as their capabilities, which is actually not the case, because softwares and technology can always get taught even during your practical experience. But it's the way you challenge a brief, the way you, you know, experiment with within practical boundaries is something that they need to be very aware of, is how I would look at it. And these are the guys who are going to design for the new generation, which the developer is also, you know, catering to today, who have absolutely extreme demands today.
Rahul, to my mind, is a little bit on the neutral grounds where he works with Everest Industries and deals with designers, architects, vendors, developers, and he has a lot of insight on all the pieces in the puzzle and how they can work together. So I'd request you to throw some light on that.
I'll probably give you more of a management or a consultant's perspective. My experience tells me that this, there's an entire ecosystem which works. Now, when you have a construction project, you have a site, there's an entire ecosystem which is working, which is you have the end client or the or you have the customer, you have the developer, you have the architects and designers, you have the various consultants, whether they're acoustic consultants, structural consultants, engineering consultants. And this goes on, you have the contractors, subcontractors, right down to the entire labor community, which is extremely diverse in India. And there's a large migrant force which comes in. They are diverse culturally. And unless you have this entire ecosystem in sync of what your objectives are, where do you want to get, the time frames, the kind of quality of work, the delivery that you expect. And it's a big piece of communicating to them that this is what we want, this is what we how we want it delivered. And that's where I think the entire framework of, I mean, or the picture of teamwork probably comes into place. Initially, of course, there's getting the brief right, getting the specifications right. Our experience in India is that you have a brief, you have a design, you go about it, and then everybody wants to do a force fitting towards the end of it, saying you fit something here, fit something there, and this thing. So discuss this, sort it out right at the beginning. I think life becomes a lot easier and execution becomes a lot easier within certain time limits. These are the challenges that are there and have always been there, but I think today the world is evolving and we are moving in the right direction.